We have already talked about an important feature of quantum mechanics, entanglement. Entanglement is extremely useful for quantum cryptography. You have probably heard about another principle of quantum mechanics, namely the uncertainty principle. As we will see, the uncertainty principle is also extremely useful for quantum cryptography. You are probably aware of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, who we see here, originally defined in terms of position and momentum. In particular, Heisenberg discovered that it is impossible to prepare any quantum state such that we can predict both the outcome of a position and a momentum measurement. A long time has passed since Heisenberg made his discovery, and these days people like to think about uncertainty as a game. Let's consider a game which Alice and Eve will play. In particular, Eve will play against Alice. Eve can prepare any quantum state, rho A, that she wants, and here you should be thinking that this is just a single qubit. Eve sends the state to Alice, who randomly chooses a bit theta. Theta equals 0 with probability half, and theta being 1 with probability half. If she chose theta being 0, she's going to measure in the standard basis. For theta equals 1, she's going to measure in the Hadamard basis. She will get one bit of measurement outcome, which I will call x. To be fair, Alice tells Eve which measurement she performed. Eve wins the game if she correctly manages to guess Alice's measurement outcome x. This may seem quite abstract, and you might be wondering, what does this have to do with uncertainty? To see why this captures uncertainty, let's have a look at the following expression. If it was true that for all states rho A that Eve can prepare, the average of the probability of guessing the outcome if theta was 0, and the probability of guessing the outcome if theta was 1, if that is strictly less than 1, then this means that there's some amount of uncertainty. If Eve's state is such that she can perfectly predict the outcome of the measurement in the standard basis, meaning that this here would be equal to 1, then if this constant here is less than 1, it means that she's necessarily uncertain about the outcome in the Hadamard basis. For this example, 1 qubit in the standard and Hadamard basis, C can be written as follows. We thus see that just like the monomy of entanglement cannot be circumvented by anyone, also the uncertainty principle imposes an unavoidable physical limitation on Eve. There is just no state that she can prepare that allows her to do any better, even if she had a quantum computer and is much smarter than Alice. You can think that what the uncertainty principle says is really that quantum mechanics does not allow Eve to do any better. We have already seen the min entropy. It will be quite convenient to express this probability of guessing in terms of the min entropy. This gives us what is known as an entropic uncertainty relation. Let me remind you that this is an inherent limitation in Eve's guessing game. So here there's a constant which is less than 1. This is true even if Eve gives some classical information, about the state that she prepared. So K is a classical register that contains some information, which density matrix or what other information that Eve may collect. I've written K here to emphasize that Eve holds some additional information. Let's remember that the min entropy is nothing else but minus the log the probability of guessing X given everything that Eve has. And what Eve has here is potentially some classical register K, and of course the basis information theta that Alice sent her. So the guessing probability is nothing else than this expression. With probability half, we have theta being 0, and then this is the probability that Alice guesses, that Eve guesses the outcome. And with probability half, we have the Hadamard basis, and this is the probability that Eve manages to guess the outcome if Alice measured in the Hadamard basis. This is precisely the term that we saw above. We thus see that we could have written this uncertainty relation in terms of a lower bound on the min entropy. So the C is just the C from up here. An upper bound on the guessing probability can thus be turned into a lower bound on the min entropy. This way of writing down uncertainty is known as an entropic uncertainty relation. And in the lecture notes, you can find some pointers to the literature where you can read all about such relations. So far, I have said that Eve may just have some classical information. But you might be wondering, what actually happens if Eve has quantum information or Eve has entanglement with A? This means that when she prepares the state rho A and sends it to Alice, rho A is actually entangled with a system E that Eve keeps. It turns out that in this case, Eve could avoid uncertainty. In particular, if we imagine that the state shared between Alice and Eve is the following, namely, it's just the EPR pair, you can see that because we can write the EPR pair both in terms of the standard basis and in terms of the Hadamard basis, all that Eve has to do is to wait until Alice announces which basis she has chosen. Then Eve can measure her qubit E in the correct basis and gets precisely the same measurement outcome as Alice. She can guess X perfectly. This effect that entanglement reduces uncertainty has already been observed a long time ago by Einstein, Podolsky, and Rosen. We have seen that if there's no entanglement, or if Eve just has classical information, then there is a large amount of uncertainty. In the example we consider, you might want to convince yourself that the min entropy is roughly 0.22. If there is maximum entanglement, there is no uncertainty. Eve can guess perfectly, and the min entropy is 0. It turns out that there's quite a nice trade-off between these two extremes. If Eve is somewhat entangled with Eve, then there is also some uncertainty, and this can be quantified. These are known as entropic uncertainty relations with quantum side information, and you will find pointers to the literature in the lecture notes. In particular, this relation says that for any kind of measurement that Alice might perform, there exists some function fm, m indicating that this function will depend on the measurements that Alice does. And of course, it depends on the a priori amount of entanglement between A and E. if you remember the fully quantum mean entropy, then in the mean entropy between A and E, in fact, measures exactly how far or how close Eve can bring the state rho AE to the maximally entangled state, maximum entanglement, by performing an operation on E. And for the maximal entangled state, we have no uncertainty. We have seen now what the uncertainty principle looks like in a modern way that allows us to use it directly for cryptographic protocols.